My name's Chaitin Black. You might have heard of my mother, Amelia. She owns the Falcon Company. I guess I'd recovered enough from my war wounds to make a nuisance of myself. So she sent me out west on company business. Said it'd be good for me. I agreed to go, but only so I could reconnect with my Lakota uncle and see an old friend from my days in the Union Army.
¿Eres el de la compañía Halcón, Chaitin Black?
Mi bisabuela era iroquesa y mi padre era Lakota Sioux.
Bienvenido a Fort Laramie. Soy Bill Holm, el furriel.
Mi padre murió cuando yo era niño. Me crié con mi madre.
El coronel Carrington me pidió que te escoltara al sendero de Bowsman.
Da igual. Sigamos.
Dicen que Halcón va a abrir un par de estaciones en este territorio.
Hacer esta carnicería está mal.
¿Sabes? No te imaginaba así. ¿Eres indio?
Busquemos a los asesinos.
Ah, me da igual lo que seas, pero te aconsejo que no lo digas muy alto.
Madre, ¿cuándo has llegado?
Los Sioux no son muy queridos por aquí.
No lo habría logrado sin mi amigo Billy Holm.
Lo siento, chaval. No quería...
Para esos guerreros Sioux, era algo personal. Estaban furiosos.
Ah, tendrían que haber seguido el sendero. Es territorio Sioux.
Los Sioux no son como imaginaba. Me dijiste que mi padre era muy pacífico.
Vi a muchos morir en Antietam y en Gettysburg, chaval. No es agradable, pero te acostumbras.
La paz entre los colonos y los Sioux no durará. Así que, eres el Sheriff Holm. Me alegro de verte, Billy. Partí con mi caballo en cuanto recibí tu carta. ¿Qué querías enseñarme?
Ihonilochche, nephew. You can call me Uncle Frank, if you'd like.
Oro!
This name was given to me by the Christians when they first visited us. I didn't care for them all that much. But I kind of liked the way Frank Warbonnet sounded.
Los Sioux volverán. Y esta vez, con más fuerza.
It is good you have come. When your father passed, we were saddened that you were taken so far away. However, I'm happy to see my nephew has turned out to be a strong warrior, like his father.
Los bandidos querían el oro, pero los Sioux son sus tierras. No deberíamos ocuparlas.
This is good, nephew. But what is your concern with this Falcon Company?
De acuerdo. Debemos detener esto antes de que se declare la guerra.
This might be so. But at what expense? Your mother's company continues to bring white settlers by the trainload. They slaughter the bison, attack our people. They do not understand what it means to be in good relations. I'm afraid your mother has lost her way. Your father would be disappointed to hear this news.
¿Qué has hecho? Los Sioux querían negociar. Caballo Loco me dijo que los mineros quebrantaron la tregua. ¿Es cierto?
Sí, el representante de la ley electo en estos lares y tu humilde servidor.
El sheriff y sus bandidos se ocultan en las colinas. Les acompaña casi todo el pueblo.
Me han dicho que diriges la compañía Halcón. Te aconsejo que veas lo que hemos encontrado.
Me llamo Chayton Black. Soy dueño del ferrocarril.
A espuertas, todo nuestro.
El sheriff Holm ha alimentado las rencillas entre los Sioux y los mineros.
Nos haremos ricos y tú puedes formar parte.
Pretende expulsar a los Sioux de sus tierras para quedarse con el oro.
Les pierde la avaricia. Todos quieren nuestro oro.
Deme un día.
Pues lárgate y busca a tu viejo amigo caballo loco. Intenta que entre en razón.
Traeré a Holm y oirá la verdad de sus labios.
Al final encontraste a caballo loco, chaval. Como en los viejos tiempos, ¿eh?
¿Piensas decirme por qué, Billy?
Ihanelachi, you've returned, nephew.
Estas tierras pertenecen a los Sioux. Si se tratase de los colonos, ¿los habrías asesinado también?
Yes, nephew. This has been known, and we will fight.
Vendrás conmigo.
Do you know what the cow does when the winter wind blows in the dead of winter?
Tendrás que probar.
The cow turns away and puts its back to the wind. And do you know what the Tatanka, the bison, does?
General Custer. Pero...
It turns to the wind and faces it head on. Out here, the settlers' cows freeze to death. But the Tatanka survive. We too are survivors. And we will face this wind head on.
Ha muerto.
The 7th Cavalry will fall on our camp. When the time comes, the tribes must be united. And it will be your job to make sure they are ready.
General, si hablara con toro sentado o caballo loco.
What is that, nephew?
Tiene razón. No puedo.
The truce was broken. The miners led by the sheriff attacked one of our neighboring camps at night, killing many innocent people. We must defend our lands and our people.
Adiós, señor.
I saw him with my own eyes. Many here recognize him from the fort.
That lying coward. There you are.
Te equivocas. Asesinarán a todo lo que se ponga delante.
To imagine this whole time, you were the leader of the hole-in-the-wall gang.
¿Qué más da?
My uncle told me everything.
Ha empezado la guerra y los Sioux nos persiguen. ¡Deprisa!
And all this time, I had refused to believe the rumors about you during the war. Back then, the fella said you went out at night to take the gold teeth from dead soldiers, and worse. But I always stuck up for you.
Ya lo sabes. Viste las minas.
If I were you, I'd start walking away right about now.
Me habría solucionado la vida, habría sido rico.
Don't tempt me.
Su sangre es del mismo color. El oro es lo que importa, chaval, nada más.
Pardon me?
¿Quién está al mando?
The name is Chayton Black, with the Falcon Company. I would address you as general, but since your demotion, is it lieutenant now?
Tienes cara de Sioux.
I'm sure you've heard of the trouble around here. The former sheriff, Billy Holm, has started a war with the Lakota, and was leading the hole-in-the-wall gang to steal from the mining camps and the company. I would advise you to stay here while I bring Holm to justice and put an end to this war. We won't need you or your men after that.
George Armstrong Custer. Me han enviado para frenar los saqueos indios en la región.
Mm.
All this killing and lying, ¿for what? ¿Gold?
Nada de lo que yo diga impedirá que Caster masacre a tus amiguitos, Sius.
¿By murdering innocent people and stealing from the company?
No, chaval. Claro que no.
Enough talk. I'm taking you in. Well then, it'll just have to be a hanging.
I should have let you die all those years back.
Here's your chance, Holm. Why don't you finish the job?
El problema indio es más importante que un sheriff de tres al cuarto, señor Black.
Reverted Lieutenant Colonel Custer. Holm has been taken care of, and the Lakota will no longer be a threat.
Los Sioux y los Cheyennes regresarán a las reservas o se las verán conmigo.
Because I'm hoping you're a reasonable man, and I know we can settle this without more bloodshed.
Haga lo que quiera, estaré acampado aquí un tiempo.
Civilizing through killing innocent women, children, and elders? This isn't soldiering, it's savagery, and I won't stand for it.
The supply trains are 50 miles back, and I'm not moving until my whole command is in position.
I was just thinking about how you'll be the butt of Indian jokes for years to come.
Le concedo un día, Brad. Aprovecha.
You did well, nephew. I'm proud. And your father would be proud, too.
Thank you, Uncle Frank.
I would ask you to stay, but you seem to already have your heart set.
I think I've caused enough trouble. So many have died, Uncle.
Yes, this is true. But perhaps it was Custer who had to die, for all their transgressions.
Let's hope the lesson was learned. But just in case, I will continue the fight back east.
And remember, no matter where you come from or where you are, you will always have value. But it's up to you what you do with it.
Thank you, Uncle. Doksha Ake.